This is actually an innovative project which consists of an autonomous security drone with a docking station that can be deployed for 24/7 in crisis situation, be it in criminal activities or calamities or in fire incidents. It is a technology that can make a difference between life and death. According to some of the experts from the fire brigade, for example, the first 2 minutes are extremely crucial to know where the source is and how it's actually progressing. But experiences actually showed that the smart sensor activated alarms are most of the time, 80% of them are false positive, which means if it is actually false positive, it costs time, energy, and also, of course, other resources, including money. So, if you use this type of technology, you can actually spend less time, less energy, and then less resources. And besides that, you can carry out this type of emergency responses effectively and efficiently. So the different stakeholders came with different types of questions which are more or less related. So what we have actually done is that we brought them together. Together with our public and private partners, we formed a consortium, and as Saxion, we play a central role not only in coordinating but also in developing the technological aspects and making sure that what we have developed is correctly tested in operational environment, so that ultimately this innovation can be integrated in the working process of our end user partners. In all our research activities, our research engineers play a significant role, indispensable role, but similarly our students are also in different forms involved in this type of projects. They can provide some results, but at the same time they also learn about the current state of the art. Space 53 actually plays a significant role in making sure that the technologies that we develop here can be properly tested in natural environments, so that the technology readiness level can be higher, so that we get a very fast feedback loop, so that we can improve our technologies. One aspect is unlimited test environment. The other aspect is also the networking. As I said, within this project, for example, Busenkol drone experts, which are members of our Space 53 ecosystem, are also involved. The other aspect is, in order to integrate technology, this type of technological innovations, technology only is not the only solution. There are other aspects, the ethical, social, and legal aspects that we need to take into account, including business. Last but not least, Space 53 is also an ecosystem which plays a significant role in lobbying. This project is primarily for security application, specifically to make sure that we can save life, or we actually significantly prevent properties from completely being damaged. But the technologies that we have developed, be it the docking station, which is able to charge the battery, even actually swap the battery, and the autonomy that we have equipped our drones with, are generic and modular, and they can be applied for other sectors and for other types of drones. For example, the Mars 4Rs, which is intended to develop a flying hand that can be used in order to inspect and maintain green energy sources such as wind turbines and solar panels. We have also a REPS project, which is going to be deployed in order to detect the caterpillars, in order to eliminate them at early stage before they develop this irritating hair. We have also developed another type of drone for agricultural applications, which can carry out a selective spraying of plants, so that the sickness can be treated locally without using a lot of materials a lot of chemicals. So this technology, all the things that we have developed are generic and modular, and it can easily be reused. You can consider them as building blocks. We valorize our knowledge that we have we develop in all these projects in two channels. One is the companies, and the others are actually our students. So with our students, we try to incorporate, involve them, and then also the results should be properly incorporated in the educational system. That's actually our business case, one aspect. The other aspect, which is actually the companies. The companies are actually involved in our technological development process together, so that, as I already mentioned, we facilitate them in improving the product or the service that they have already been providing, but it also create new opportunities so that they can actually integrate a new service or new products in their lineup. The third aspect is when there are new technologies, there are other channels like spin-outs and spin-offs. And for example, for the docking stations that we have developed, which is generic and modular, we have already a spin-off that actually started. So we integrate it with our company partners, with our students, but if there are also other unique aspects, innovative solutions, be it a product or a service, we also stimulate spin-outs and spin-offs. I think an optimal combination of the rule and regulation, the ethical aspects, the awareness that we create in the society, coupled with the technological development and the business aspect, would be significantly helpful. I have no doubt within a few years, when everything is sorted out, including the rules and regulations, that we will actually see a network of the beast, the autonomous drone with a docking station all over the Netherlands. The ecosystem, and here the Netherlands in general, would be the leader in deploying drones with autonomy, and then also with 24/7 deployability with the help of the docking station, would be the first one to completely overhaul the emergency response.